Biological cells contain, consume, and produce a multitude of small molecules called metabolites, which participate in various biochemical reactions and transport processes. Confronted with this complexity, how can we better understand the mechanisms underlying cellular functions? Let's imagine metabolites in a specific cell type as cities on a map of the United States. The roads between the metabolites correspond to biochemical processes, forming a metabolic network of interconnected metabolites. A collection of reactions within such a network that forms a functional group is called a pathway, comparable to a traffic map just showing California. Genetic activity has the role of traffic lights and regulates the flow through the network. A genome-scale network comprises all processes for which the organism encodes regulatory functions on its DNA. In order to build and analyze such complex networks, specific software tools and knowledge representation resources are prerequisite. The web application Escher allows us to draw and connect entire reaction pathways. We can display measurement data on networks, for instance, to trace the flow of C13 marked molecules. From neatly arranged pathways, we can better recognize the flow of metabolites within cellular systems. A metabolic network becomes a model when we add mathematical equations describing the network behavior that allows us to run computer simulations. By storing our models in the community file format, SBML, we can easily share these models within the scientific community and analyze them in a variety of scientific apps. Computer programs such as Cobra Pi perform complex analyses that can calculate, for example, how much biomass a cellular system can produce in a steady state. The Big Models knowledge base distributes many published genome-scale models. When we build networks in Escher, we can combine information from big models to a richer picture of the pathways. Just like in traffic, the flow through the network is not constant, but varies over time, depending on the amount of energy and matter available. In order to simulate molecules in a dynamic state, kinetic equations must be derived for all reactions. This can be very difficult and error-prone. Fortunately, SBML Squeezer attaches kinetic equations to each reaction and derives their parameters with units. SBML Simulator in turn interprets these systems and calibrates the models to experimental data. The systems biology software solutions described here have been created or extended as part of a collaboration between the University of Tübingen and the University of California, San Diego. For more information, visit systems-biology.info.